This figure deals with the bicarbonate buffer system. The system's reactions are nicely summarized by the carbonic acid equation, which is shown here. That is well named because right in the center of the action, we have carbonic acid, or H2CO3. In aqueous solutions, carbon dioxide, CO2, will combine with water in a hydration reaction to produce H2CO3. As an acid, H2CO3 has a tendency to dissociate, at least to a certain extent, into protons and bicarbonate ions. Notice that the reactions shown in the carbonic acid equation are both reversible. We can have them move from the left to the right. We call that forward. Or we can have them move in the opposite direction, from right to left. That is called reverse. As a good example of this, look at the left side of the equation, carbon dioxide. Cell metabolism produces carbon dioxide in cell respiration, specifically the Krebs cycle. As the CO2 level builds in the body fluids, that then has a tendency to drive these reactions to the right, that is, in a forward direction. The respiratory system, specifically the lungs, can control the rate at which CO2 is eliminated into the exhaled air. And as they do that, and the CO2 level falls in the body fluids, that would then have a tendency to drive the reaction shown here in the reverse direction. Notice also the hydration of CO2 in water will occur spontaneously, but the rate at which it does occur is very, very slow. Oftentimes, when physiological systems need this to happen, they need it to happen much more quickly. And so cells involved in those systems express an enzyme called carbonic anhydrase, or CA. That enzyme dramatically speeds up the hydration of CO2. The organ systems that need this to occur then capitalize on that. Let's now shift our attention to the right side of the equation, where the protons and bicarbonate are shown. We have an interesting situation here. The kidneys have the ability to pretty powerfully control the rate at which both protons and bicarbonate ions are excreted in the urine. And generally speaking, what the kidneys will do is, in one situation, if the body's in a low pH stress, the kidneys can increase the proton content of the urine and reduce the bicarbonate concentration of the urine. In situations that are the opposite, like if we have an alkaline challenge to the body, the kidneys can do the reverse. As you can imagine, as the kidneys manipulate proton and bicarbonate levels in the urine, they can affect a shift in the direction of the carbonic acid equation as necessary. Final point, bicarbonate ions never exist in aqueous solutions all by themselves. The law of electroneutrality says that we have to have an equal number of cations. So, as a result, almost invariably, we indicate that sodium is present along with the bicarbonate. So, as a result, frequently, we express bicarbonate in a fluid as the salt, sodium bicarbonate, which can then dissociate into sodium and bicarbonate ions.